Well, it is lunchtime. As I break my dang neck, these rocks are slick. I remembered everything that I needed for today's hunt except for my GoPro, which I hate because the audio is constantly messing up. But I'm going to do a little midday wrap up because I got on top of the bullets. Daniel found a coin that I thought I was going to have to travel somewhere to get to see it dug. So, I mean, that's cool. So I'm just going to show you what we have found. What's up, guys? We are back on the river. The schedule has been off. We've had some rain. The river's been up. Amanda and I, we were planning on hitting this a couple more times during the week, but we weren't able to. I've got Danny Boy here.
Hi.
From Magic City Metal Detecting, and we're going to hopefully find a new Civil War crossing. We're going to get to digging. All right, guys. Well, I told you that I felt that Amanda and I had left off right where I felt like the crossing was going to be. But anyways, check this out. Here's the first two targets I dug. It's gonna be two horseshoes right there, two horseshoe pieces. All right, check this out. This was my third target. I don't know if you can see under the water. Look at that. Just look at it. Oh, we're on it. Hopefully this isn't a fluke. Turn this thing back on if we find more.
B-roll, test. I'm here with the Bullet Whisperer. I'm about to get out on some water.
Say what?
What kind of coin?
Bring it closer. Modern, penny size?
Lincoln scared me though.
I'm working a button signal.
I'm trying to see if it's a reading. It's a reading.
Is it?
I believe, yeah. Better than nothing.
It wasn't a button signal.
Showing kind of deep.
Get it.
I was reading like a damn coin.
Well, I wouldn't mind coming up on a spill again.
I know the bottom's a lot different here, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure.
You got it out. Dude, what is that? Dude! You kidding me right now?
Yeah.
Did I call that one?
You did. What you got? Is it a Sharps? Oh yeah. The Bullet Whisperer. I said it.
That intuition, baby.
Yeah, man. Nice. All right.
GoPro.
I'll hold it down over here. I don't mind digging some bullets. All right. First live dig was a success. That's rare.
Oh, you were filming?
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry for the language, folks. I didn't know I was on camera.
Just for giggles. Piece of barbed wire. Something right on the surface, beeping. A lot of iron. Might be a horseshoe. No, big piece of plate or something. Let me pull that out real quick. Maybe it's a cartridge box. Or a plow point. Don't know. Throw it up here on the bank. Oi! We'll pick that up later. Zach might have another one. We don't know. We're just going to film in case. The last one, as soon as you swept that one and you saw that white.
Yeah. Well, we're getting tore up on this pull test, man. This one was reading 6870.
Every year, variety out here.
Yeah. Oh. Gotta dig them, man.
That's a nice one.
Dig it up.
That's tiny, too, man. Hit that real quick. Let me see if that falls on your bullet radar.
It's hitting in the 50s, but I'd still dig it.
Of course.
The only thing that worries me is it did a double tap on me.
All right, we go for it. I'll have y'all know I'm doing this one-handed. It's not what I'm used to. Makes it very difficult. I didn't bring a lanyard for this detector.
Just drop the metal detector at your ankles and let the water push it against your shins.
And this water will definitely sweep it away. Feels like it's under some rocks. Oh God. Yeah. Oh brother. Oh brother. Oh God dang it. I wish this pin would shut up. I don't know if y'all saw or you can see what's in my hand, but the first thing I saw was a date. And I hope it's filming okay. Zach's gonna get his camera. Oh man. I can't not believe this is my third one of these. Second one out of this river.
All right, I got a bullet signal over here and Daniel stopped me. He's kind of freaking out. So let's see what he's got.
I don't want to leave this spot right here because there's another signal.
All right. Hold on.
I think I did it again, man. Fish around in that dirt real quick.
Uh-oh. Do you want me to pluck it?
Yep.
You're seated. Are you kidding me? Hold on, I'm just gonna. Yeah, you clean it up because I only got one hand here.
No, it's not seated.
What is it?
I think it's a cat bust.
Is it?
Cat bust half dime.
No way.
The eagle, I saw the eagle in the back.
I couldn't see anything.
You've got to be kidding me.
Is it?
It's a cat bust.
Let's see.
God. Oh, she's gorgeous. 1831.
Holy snap, dude. I didn't think I'd ever see one of these come out of the ground.
I'm high right now.
I bet. What was it reading?
Oh my God, you hit it. Same as that same signal. It just had a 22, 21.
Yeah, it was double tapping on mine.
Yeah, on this machine.
It's in the 50s.
There's a 16 on the Knox behind it and then a 22, and that's what I just pulled out.
Yeah, I was like, I dig it, you know?
Woo!
That is insane, man. I didn't think I'd ever see one of those come out of the ground.
Yeah, man.
Dude, right here.
It's worth it right there.
Here you go.
God, dog.
I think we're getting onto a little something, something. I'll get close-ups later, all right?
I'm not going to touch it. I'm going to just stow it away.
Yes. All right, here's the signal that was next to that half dime. I mean, I'm talking within an inch, so I'm just gonna go for that one. It's reading a pull tab range, but
let's see what it is.
Something down here in the rocks. This stuff is hard to dig in. That half dime was in a pocket. It's been getting washed over for, you know, all that time.
What do you know? Right next to it, a modern pull tab. Dig those trash signals, guys. Jeez. All right, here's a good signal in these waters. It's all been 15, 16 on this machine, pull tabs mostly. This is a 1920, 18. We'd hope that's a bullet. I'd love to pull the bullet out of here too. Keep this detector from going away.
And let the water push it against your shins.
It doesn't appear to be on the surface. Kind of like clay on the bottom. Best thing to do is just keep grabbing handfuls. It is hard to beat pulling a big, huge piece of Civil War lead out of this river. It just looks so cool, especially the dropped ones we found out here. Huge solid three ringers. Yeah, this one's deep. I'm hoping this is gonna be a bullet. Could be deep iron too. Nope. Still want to check that out though. I don't know. We'll put it in the pouch.
Another good one by the kayaks. Fairly deep. Oh. It's a really good one too. Might be a can though. Ooh, that's big. Alright. Which one first? I don't know. Let's just get this guy out. If I can. This one seems like it's going to be deep. Keep thinking I got a bullet in my hand. Oh, man. Big sinker. Alright, let's see what this big guy is over here. I'm thinking can. Seem really long. No, it seems pipe-ish. No, it's a can. Yeah. Coca-Cola Classic. All right, this is the same signal Zach dug that first bullet. On this machine, 1718. So, you better believe I'm gonna film it and dig it and hope that's what it is. A bullet, a coin, and a button would be fantastic for me today. Even a fired. Although, a drop bullet is more likely out of here. Unless they were just a really bad shot or shooting into the water. Come on now. Oh man, not again. It keeps happening. Another sinker. All right, no worries. I'll dig those all day.
You can see
the why. Just gonna do this.
Let's go under.
Boom.
We here?
Literally, boom.
It's gonna take us a little longer here, I think.
Oh man, I'm fine with it.
Spread out.
If I find like that halftime once an hour, I'll stay out here until dark. Walking over to Zach. He said he's got something really effing weird.
It's got a shield on the front of it.
Whoa. Whoa, what is that?
Is that not weird? I don't know if it's period or not. That shield sure is weird, isn't it?
Whatever this threaded piece is super crude and old looking.
I mean, it could be off a dang hot water heater for all I know, but I mean, the shield and the brass just together just kind of...
It's kind of ornate to be off something industrial or... I have no idea, but see, like, it's even got the lines in the back.
Yeah, I know, just like on the front of a button.
Dang. That's interesting, and that's hooked, yeah. You know, like...
Weird, man.
What did it sound like?
70s.
It was like brass, copper.
Yeah. And that's not rubber or anything. I mean, that shield looks almost just like a general service shield.
Yeah.
A button,
yeah.
Know?
Dang, man. I'd love to figure out what that is.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out.
It's 14:15 every time on this machine, but I still do it. So we got something in the pocket. I don't quite know what I'm going for. It seems like it's all over the place. Oh, it's iron.
Oh, wow, dude. Look at that little pistol bullet.
Dang.
That's period.
Let me get over there. Yeah, buddy.
For sure. Can't remember what kind that is.
She's sure enough fired.
Weird, man, that's the second fired bullet. That's weird.
That's what I was saying earlier on camera, is like, you know, finding fired bullets out here is not common, because unless they were just bad aim or firing into the water, they're all been dropped for the most part.
Yeah, it's weird, man. I don't know why there'd be fired bullets here, especially considering that this spot was just strictly intuition. You know, I've read nothing that suggests that they should be here.
Which, by the way, if you're wondering, it's close to Myrtle Beach. I don't know what that is.
What's close to Myrtle Beach?
This spot we're at right now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, man, for sure.
Yeah. There's a Sitco gas station that we love going to that sells pool floats.
Uh-huh.
It's a nice bullet signal. Seems like it's kind of tight and small. Look at that.
Oh.
She got it.
Still got the brass on it.
Let me get over there. I keep turning my camera on for a good signal, and as soon as I pull my crap out, you have something nice in your hand.
Go ahead, I'll turn mine on and I'll be kind of
right here, huh? Oh, that's killer.
I'm gonna have to go lay that one on the bank.
Yeah, for sure.
I might. Still got some gunpowder in it, looks like.
Yeah. Man, killing all these bullets.
I'll trade you these bullets for that dime.
Ye└················I don't know. That one's gonna have me lit for a while.
Dude, you know me. As long as stuff's coming out of the ground, I'm happy.
And I'm happy to dig it. You've managed to put me on a few of my firsts, and I forever grateful. We both got good signals. Let me see. So this is a bullet, right? This is your bullet.
Let me
swung it.
Oh yeah, go ahead. It's a little choppy. It got choppy in the end.
Whew. I don't know. That's higher than a bullet. Well.
It was hitting, it was going from 63 to 78 on mine.
That might be a bullet with a jacket still on it.
Which is a digger. Alright, it's shallow, man, I doubt it.
Might be trash.
Yeah, it's probably trash, because my machine's just going crazy. Hope, maybe it's the breastplate. Might be the box plate.
Be delicious.
Did I just move it? Man, I've been wanting one of these all day.
That's a big
quite
one.
Literally, I'm thirsty.
Pinpointing small. Wouldn't be the first that's seen you dig out of the water. Jesus. Look at you, man. What a freaking roll. They're all the same too, huh?
Yeah. You know what? I bet it was infantry right through here.
Yeah, come all the way down through. Yeah, you're on the
bullet board.
You're on the bullets for sure.
Still trying to find my first coin.
This has to be one.
I don't know, I think I hit that. Oh yeah, dude, that might be a large scent. It's not even touching the 60s.
It's small too. Don't you skunk me. But it's right on top.
Is it?
Got me worried. No, it was under a rock. I just want to see that white. Maybe it's a 69 caliber.
Could be a big old musket ball, reading as high as it was.
Well, it was buried under that rock. I'm moving it around.
There it is. Golly. I thought it was a musket ball.
I thought it was an infield. Oh, that's fun. That is fun still. That is really fun.
Yeah. Sorry, I didn't mean to jerk it out of your hand.
No, it's fun. Let's see.
Swing it.
Well. Yeah, that is way more consistent. So that's right above the pull tab on what I've been digging. But we're going to watch because I trust your instinct. Is it already beeping?
Nuh-uh. Right there's the hole to the flash.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a little deep.
I'm hearing something.
Alright, I'm on top of it.
Get that bullet.
Man, this is some rough digging, you know it?
I know.
It's like digging in cobblestone.
You brought three pairs of gloves, it looked like you don't even got any on.
I know, I took it off the film. And
whoa.
What is that?
Oh no. I saw the green and kind of tripped me out.
Dude, my eyes crossed when I saw the green. I was like, what is that? I'm not sure, dude. Oh, man, that's old. Look at how off-centered those holes are.
Yeah, it's super crude. That might have been where a lock slid into a box, chest, something like that. It's
an
so,
ammo box?
Yep, so green, man. All right, I'm going to change batteries because it looks like
this
we're about
to start
filming.
This is pretty fun, you know?
Yeah. All right, I'm going to go get another battery put in the thing. Oh, it's all
he
dirty.
He probably would have done
40
gun
out. All right, I'm taking my pouch off to go change the battery on this camera, and Zach just said he thinks he's got a bullet. You do have a bullet.
It's so fun. That one was only like 2 inches deep. You know what we gotta do when it gets cold? We gotta go door knock these people's houses.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna go change batteries. I'm gonna get one too. Oh, did you move my detector so you can get in that spot?
Look at that, it's a piece of a silver ring.
Oh, that's killer. That's an old one too.
Yeah, I rechecked the hole. I thought I might have broke it, but apparently not.
It's probably just been tumbled so much that it's silver, though. You can tell by the weight.
Yep, I agree with that.
That's pretty sweet, ain't it?
That's awesome.
When expecting that.
Yeah, small signal.
Yeah. It was hitting like 82s all the way around. I thought it was going to be maybe a coin, but I'll take it.
All right, I had a high. Well, just a good signal. Well, I'm coming through too loud, but I've been working at it. I think I'm down to it finally. Ooh, it's pinpointing small stuff, man. Oh, look. There we go. I fired a round ball. Nice. Technically, that counts as a bullet.
Good deal.
All right, I've been working down to this one. It's right on the rocks. I'm not quite sure. It's like a leaf pattern. Some kind of piece of... Oh, it's a pin. Okay. It's cleaned off. It had too much mud on it for me to really know what it was. Huh. Well, that's pretty. It's like the NBC goose. Cool. Good find. Zach says he just got a Civil War era axe head. I'm gonna go check that out.
Check that bad boy out.
Oh wow, that's great. No doubt about that. Yeah, you can probably
It's got a little damage right there. Old damage, but I'm hoping I can repurpose it. That would make a cool little hatchet, you know what?
You've done one of those, right?
Yeah. Man, that thing. You know, you got, and somebody online said that some of them are marked US and CS. You know how crazy that would be?
Yeah, check out this little gem. Not Civil War era.
Oh, wow, it's so beautiful. Thank you.
I said the same thing when I found it.
Quit peacocking, let's dig.
Me and Zach cut across, try to see if we can get anything else, and all I've found so far is this big dude. I'm not quite sure what this is. Solid 19. It is definitely old. Looks like it's got three rivets holding whatever that is. Maybe a piece of leather right between it. That is what a relic looks like. Okay. I'm hauling that away. I'll find Zach somewhere.
All right, guys, I'm having some crazy issues with the GoPro, so we're having to film from my phone on the water. So come over here. I'm going to try to film the bank and not the water, and I'll show you guys what I just found. It's absolutely killer. Watch out, man. Watch out, man.
A gun?
Still got the bayonet on it.
Well, I'm gonna get the water behind you, is that alright?
Here.
Whoa.
Now, briars. Check that out, y'all. Watch up. Still got the bayonet attached. It's a complete barrel. I mean, is that not freaking awesome? That's the part that they would put on the gun to stab people. If the battle got too close, if the fighting got too close, they could turn their gun into a sword and just stab people with it. Is that not awesome? Oh my God. I cannot believe this, y'all.
Keep it, Daddy.
I am. I'm just keeping it in the water. All right. We got the phone on this side of the river, so if anybody finds anything good, we'll turn it on. All right, guys, we are back at the house, and we're going to go over today's finds. I've had the worst luck with my GoPro. I didn't really get to film the other side of the river, so I don't know how this video is going to turn out. But either way, Daniel dug this mystery piece, dug this kind of pin, musket ball. I think that's a split shot. Modern nickel, and the find of the day. Cap bust, half dime. Still doesn't seem real. Just look at it. All right, found this piece of glass. Not sure how old that is. Been wanting to dig an axe head like this for a very long time. I'm gonna repurpose it. If you would like to see that in a video, let me know. Dug some lead. Dug some lead. Tiniest bullet I've ever dug. Mystery piece right here. Not sure what that would have gone to, but I'm pretty sure it's period. And my find of the day, I didn't think I'd ever find these, one of these, because I didn't know what it was until I dug it and we looked it up and I called Riley and he told me. This is a tensioner for a banjo. That is awesome. Somebody was standing on that river with a banjo and they started getting shot at and they lost their banjo. And I found this piece of it. And the Lord smiled down on us. Dude, it's been a heck of a day, man.
I'm elated.
It's been a heck of a day.
It was a good one. Thank you.
I don't have my little handle, so I don't know how this is gonna go. Yeah, it's been a while since I put a video out. Hope you enjoyed it. You guys have a good day.